All right, today we're making a 220 volt extension cord. What you'll need are the female and male ends of the appropriate plug. I am making a NEMA 650 10 gauge wire. I'm also going to need a screwdriver, some wire strippers, and an X-Acto knife, but I don't know where mine is, so I'm using my pocket knife. It's just for removing some of the sheathing on this anyway. So let's go ahead and get started. I want to clarify something before we get too far into this. I'm using 10 gauge wire. And I would like to point out that the instructions say can be used for either 30 amp or 50 amp service, and I am using this for 30 amp service. If you're going to be hitting that 50 amps, that 250 volts at 50 amps, you're going to want 6 gauge wire, not 10 gauge wire. All right, so I've removed the exterior sheathing from this wire, and as you can see, we have a black, a white, a red, and a ground. Now, with this receptacle, we're only going to need 3 of the 4, so we'll use black, white, and ground. Okay, so now we're going to open up the male end of the extension cord by removing the screws on either side of these. And again, I should say that you can pick up these at pretty much any big hardware store. Same with the wire. Okay, so it just popped open there. And as you can see inside, we have the terminals to attach our wires to. This is the clamp to hold the wire in place so you're not tugging on the terminals when you move it around. And this goes inside of there to apply some cushioning and pressure as well. I'm just going to substitute the red for the ground and not use the ground. So I'm going to clip that off right now because we don't need it. And again, I'll point out that because I'm making an extension cord for my own use, I'm not going to have to worry about running this through a wall and then worrying about some future electrician opening up the outlet and seeing the wrong colors and not knowing what they're doing. This is going to be pretty straightforward as to what's going where. So now that we have that, we should line up where the 3 are going to go in here. So we want black, white, and green, or in our case, red. So knowing that's what we want to do, when this comes through here, the wires go to their appropriate locations, you're going to want enough space, or I guess enough room, that they all fit there comfortably. So we'll have to cut this one shorter, we'll have to cut this one shorter, and we're going to have to turn this one and remove the sheath so it fits in properly. So let's see how that looks once we do that. Okay, I've gone ahead and stripped the wires, and we can see that they will actually line up quite nicely with where they need to go. Instead of trying to finagle these in here like this, what you do is you in fact just pull these out one by one. So I'll be able to put the wire in and tighten it down and get it nice, and then I can put this back in one at a time and make sure the wire's in the right spot. And at the same time, I'll run the wire through here so I can grip it. So the first step is to make sure that this is actually around the wire. So when you're pulling on it, you're pulling on here and not at the connections. Okay, I have the 3 attached, and I'll have you know that I just used a tiny little screwdriver to tighten it hand tight, and then I can't reach around the camera to tighten it really good. So I took it off camera and I really tightened these on really, really good. Good solid connection. You'd want to make sure they're on quite nicely. Okay, took some finagling, but they're all back in their proper spot. Look on the other side here. We can see we have the posts coming through. I just want to make sure this really is in the right spot before I push this back down. So I'll clamp this back down, and we'll have lots of tension or lots of pressure right here. So if you pull on the cord, you're not pulling on these posts, you're pulling on the entire bundle held in place with this bracket. All right, yeah, that's nice and tight. It's got it right by the wire there, so we are good to put the cover back on. And there you have it. That is one end done. That is the male end of our extension cord done. Let's just see how it fits. There we go. It does fit. So that's a good sign. All right, let's move on to the other end, which is this end. And I have the one in the center here. Yep. And there we go. Ooh. And we have another gripper. We should be very familiar with this already. This will wrap around the wire itself. So we'll put that inside there and make sure there's enough give that when you pull, this will hit the bottom of the whole unit and move the unit as opposed to pulling on those outlets. Screwdriver in here and popped this out. So we're gonna pop that off the bottom here because we're not gonna use it. In this particular model, I could have popped it off the back if I was gonna go out that direction, but I'm not, I'm going through the bottom. So yeah, we'll be able to run the wire through. And I want to point out that I'm actually leaving this in the same orientation that I'm working on the receptacle. And the reason for that is I don't want to mess up my wire choices. Obviously, the red, I remember, is my ground, even though it should be green. So I'm going to put the ground to here. But what about white or black? You know I did black on this side and white on this side. Black, the bigger terminal. So that's all I remember. Black is big. So I know that the bigger terminal is on the left. So I want to line up the black with the black. So this will be black, this will be white. Kind of a tip there for you to keep track of which way you're going. Okay, so as we did before, we're using the red as our ground, so we don't need this at this point. And we're going to do more of the same. We're going to bring the wire through. We're going to line up where we want to have each of these go, and we're going to cut the wire to the right length and remove the sheathing. Okay, so I have them, I line them all up. I cut them to length. I stripped them so they were exposed. And now I'm going to insert them into the proper areas here on the outlet. So these terminals, the way that they cook to the wire is they slide open. You feed the wire into the area here. You let it rest in the middle. You close it. There's a little portal where it snaps closed. So when you tighten these, they don't push up and then they'll hold the wires in place. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And we'll fast forward to what it looks like when that's done. Okay, there we go. I have the three wires in the proper locations. Again, black, red as our ground, and white to go with B, big for black, red as our ground, and white. So when that goes on there, it'll line up right. And I have tightened these to the point that my hand is sore. You want to make sure these have a really good, great connection, so don't be afraid to give it a lot of muscle. Get it as tight as you can get it. This is the one. Okay, yeah, definitely not going to get much tighter than that. So I'm going to be able to, put this back together. And I think we are going to be laughing. Okay, we're back in the saddle. Now, this isn't going to be outside. It's a semi-permanent solution for a specific purpose. I'm not using this as a do-all or a catch-all. When you're building your own, make sure you build it for your own use. These typically, if you are going to keep it around for use for multiple things, build it to that 50 amp capacity. The real takeaway from all of this is build something to your own specific needs. This video is meant to act as a mere guide. Hopefully, it gives you the fundamentals and the ideas on how to research this further and do it yourself. Properly and safely, along with proper training, of course. So, until next time, if the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. Keep your stick on the ice.